Coming to Thailand, you need a SIM card. How many operators do we have? What data package should you choose? I'm going to give you tips and recommendation buying SIM card coming to Thailand. Come on, let's go. Congratulations. If you're seeing this video, it means that you're soon going to be in Thailand. You're going to get yourself a SIM card. But first, before you actually going to buy one, let me give you some brief idea. Thailand has three main operators, AIS, dtac and TrueMove. AIS is the biggest operator in Thailand with more than 40 million users. Next is TrueMove with about 30 million users. The least small one is dtac with 20 million users. I'm giving you this information to at least you understand who is the leader operator in Thailand. Easiest place for you to buy SIM card is at the arrival hall of every airport, even Don Mueang or small airports such as Samui. But once you walk out, there'll be a different operator. Some people just randomly and buy one. But if you watch this video, I will give you details, pro and con, and you can make the most of your trip in Thailand. The picture over here indicated the mobile coverage by each operator in Thailand. As you see from the picture, AIS cover more, followed by TrueMove than dtac. It's implied that if you're going to a big city, you can use any operator depending on the package that I'm going to talk to you next. But if you're going to a small town, isolated islands, maybe two options you can just choose from is TrueMove or AIS. Make sure you spare yourself 10 or 20 minutes because sometimes the line is long. One of my friends, they cannot buy a SIM card at the airport because the car is already here to pick them up and they have to go. So make sure you spare 10 or 20 minutes and with your passport, you can buy your SIM card with. If you forgot to buy your SIM card at airport, you can buy it at every 7-Eleven in Thailand. Please note that only TrueMove is available. And this is what AIS package look like. Starting with pay as you go, 49 baht, kind of good for 1 day. 8-day plan, 299 baht. 15-day plan, 599 baht. And the biggest package is 30 days plan. 1,250 baht. The package and price depending on the data package and duration that they offer. Please note that the free unlimited social app for Facebook, Line, Instagram, WhatsApp, WeChat, TikTok and Twitter. You have free 15 baht credit call for all package. For local and international call and service, this is the price. Right next, we have TrueMove. TrueMove divide their package into two big sections. It's called unlimited, which means that you get unlimited 5G internet. The lowest package starts from 8 days, 399 baht, or 15 days, 699 baht, or you can go up to 30 days, 999 baht. Or you have option of non-stop package. The package is a little bit smaller than unlimited package. Starting by 1 day, 49 baht, 16 day, 299 baht, and 30 days, 599 baht. Basically, you got non-stop internet for certain data package. Let's say for 16 days, you got 15 gigabyte. Or 30 days, you got 30 gigabyte. And you also get free 14 social app, no data charge. Please note that for non-stop, I don't know why, they give you extra TikTok for 10 gigabyte for the package of 16 days and 30 days. This is an extra charge for each phone call, SMS, and data package, no matter what package that you choose from for TrueMove. Next, we have dtac. They only have four packages, starting by pay as you go, 49 baht. 4-day unlimited internet, 149 baht. 15-day unlimited internet, 599 baht. And their best seller one is 8-day unlimited internet for only 299 baht. However, you get only 5 free social apps, only 5. And this is the extra cost for you for each service. And this is all the information me and my team put a lot of hard work in it. If you like what I do, please at least like this video or subscribe to my channels. My name is Chon. This channel is supposed to give you tips, recommendations as a local perspective to make your trip to Thailand be a better one. Don't forget to check out other videos, right? Like, subscribe this video, please. Sometime at the airport, you might see DTAC giving away SIM card. Before you getting DTAC SIM card, make sure that you stay at the cities because the signal from suburb, it might not be excellent. And the amount and data that they give you is quite small. You have to top up the money anyway. And once you want to top up, it might be difficult for you to find a way to top up your SIM card. Just make sure it's worth your time. Let's say you forgot to buy your SIM card at the airport. You don't have to be worried. You can buy SIM card at any convenience store in Thailand. Either DTAC, TrueMove, AIS, it is not hard for you to buy one. Just make sure you have your passport with you. One thing that I want you to recommend you that if you come as a group, buy the same operator because you can get to call each other for free. Write each other number down, put it on your phone, make a local call. And this is the useful local number, the tourist information, immigration. I hope you find this video helpful. And if you're coming to Thailand, I wish you having a good time in Thailand. If you have any question, make sure you put it on the comment down below. I read every comment. My name is Chon. This is my city, my country. I'm doing my best to give you tips and recommendations. Make sure to check out other videos as well. Bye bye for now. สวัสดีครับ